Sensei Robert Alpern. And tonight what I'm going to show you is not a technique from curriculum. Rather, it's an actual physical altercation that I had been in. And this is when I was working in security. I was actually a correctional officer working for the probation department. And this is actually one of the techniques that I had used in one of the encounters. And my goal is to show you what your training can help you do if you train long enough and hard enough and you get to that point where you just react according to the moment. So what I'd like to do is just share some of my experiences with you, and these are not things from the curriculum. Rather, they are things that have actually been used in the field on the job and throughout my years and my career. So hope you enjoy this. And again, this is just something that worked for me that I'd like to share with you guys. So again, this is an escort, escorting someone back to their cell, having a hand placed on the elbow here, lightly, and the other hand was up in a guarded position, just in case. And on a moment's notice, the inmate tried to elbow with the left, where I checked it, hooked him in. Now, the thing I wanted to do was to keep from a headbutt or anything, I wanted to close this distance between he and I. So as I wrapped the arm up, cross-faced him to pull him into me. And we'll do this from the other side so you can see it from the other direction. Again, a hand here, and then skull here. Checking the cross, hooking, pulling him in. And you notice I'm cupping his covering his face, his mouth, with the back of my hand so he couldn't bite me or spit on me. And then wrapping and trapping that arm, using my fist in the back to push his lower back out and get him off balance a little bit. Okay, so we'll go back to the original position. So from here, strikes, coming in, then rotating around, pushing him off in the other direction. From here, I twist down into a corkscrew or into a kneeling stance, and he goes down to his side. Then I brace on my wrist and I push forward until he's down into the prone position. Now, if he decides to cup this hand and not let me have the hand so I can cup, I place pressure on the shoulder with direction. I let him know I'm going to put some pressure on your shoulder unless you give me your arm. And I tell him, and then I start to push forward, which you see now he's very compliant and wants to give me that arm. Then I can take him here, trap, and then bam, bam, place the cuffs on. And that's pretty much what we had done. Come on up. And we'll do that one more time real quick from the other direction here. So again, as the strike came in, blocking, checking, switching it around, bringing down, cutting across and locking, put it out there, thank you very much. And then take the arm here, place it to the back, check, I put my elbow on his wrist to keep it down, cuff goes in place, done and done. Thank you, sir. And that's pretty much how that incident went. Hope you enjoyed it. Thank you.